Hey guys, it is Sara here. So today I am, as you read by the title and saw the thumbnail, that's why you clicked on this video, but today I am going to be showing you guys how I made these chocolate cake pops slash cake balls, if you will. And honestly, I love recipe videos. I don't do them as often because they take so much time, but I loved editing it and I loved filming it, and honestly, I just love this video overall. I do want to say that you could kind of title this video a fail. I didn't in the end because I loved the end results, but I was actually planning on making a cake, like an actual cake with layers. But as you'll see in the video, some things went wrong and I had to kind of change my direction. So I ended up making cake pops, which I actually liked better in the end. And yeah, these taste amazing. Literally, they were gone in like 3 hours and I made 60 balls. So yeah, you might want to try these out. They're very easy to do, and if you want to see how to make them, then just keep on watching.
So for this recipe, you will need 1 cup of chocolate chips melted, 4 eggs, 2 cups of yogurt, 3 cups of brown sugar, 4.5 cups of flour along with 2 teaspoons of baking powder and 1 tablespoon of baking soda, 1 cup of butter, and 1 cup of water. So first I just mixed the butter into my KitchenAid and just kind of beat that until the color was a little bit lighter and the butter was fluffy. Next, I added in the brown sugar and mixed that in as well. Started on low speed and then worked my way up to high speed. Then I added in the eggs one at a time, so I cracked one, then mixed, and then cracked one and mixed again. So once I did that, I added the vanilla and the melted chocolate all at once and then mixed that in as well. So once that was incorporated, I added half of the flour mixture with the baking powder and baking soda and then mixed that in, and I started out slowly because it kind of goes everywhere, and then just mixed that until it was incorporated. We don't want to overmix. And then I added half of the yogurt and half of the water and mixed that in just until it was incorporated again. Don't overmix or else your cake will be very stiff and not fluffy. And then I just added the rest of the flour mixture and mixed that in. I just added the rest of the yogurt and water that was left and mixed that in. So once all of that was mixed, I kind of scraped the sides of the bowl just to make sure everything was incorporated. And this is optional, that's why I didn't put it on the ingredients list, but I added like a good big spoon of Nutella because I just kind of wanted that kick of chocolatiness to it, if that makes sense. And that is the batter. So then I just cleaned the thing right here and went off to my cookie sheet, and I actually baked my cake on a cookie sheet, which is totally fine. I just put some wax paper down, and just so that the cakes were even, I decided to add the mixture with a ice cream scoop. Like that I know that the cakes are gonna be even. It's just an easier way for me to measure it. And then I just leveled it out. Then I just tapped the air bubbles out and just to kind of level it, and repeated that all over again with another cookie sheet. Next, I popped these into the oven that was preheated at 360 degrees Fahrenheit for 25 minutes. So once that was done, I took the cakes out and let them cool. I put them in the fridge for like 10 minutes. It's really, really important that you let it cool. So next for a frosting or buttercream, I used 1.5 cups of butter, and it's very important that you beat the butter for a very long time until it's basically white. And I beat it for 6 minutes on very high speed. So once it was light in color, I added half of 4.5 cups of icing sugar or powdered sugar and just mixed that in. And then added the other half of the icing sugar. And once all that was mixed, I just added 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract and 1 tablespoon of milk to just kind of thin it out a little bit. And that is our buttercream frosting. So here's where things went south. As you guys know, I was planning to make a cake, but that didn't work out because I tried to flip the cake out, you know, so that I could start putting the frosting on top of it, and it did not want to come out. It was like stuck in there. And so I tried to peel it out and I broke the cake, which honestly happens to me all the time.
Cake pops.
So obviously there was a switch of plans, and I actually liked this idea better anyway, so I just went ahead and broke the rest of the cake, which honestly felt super super satisfying. And I just put this in a bowl in kind of bigger pieces, and then I went in with my hands and broke those bigger pieces into smaller pieces until there were no more bigger pieces. So next I added about $1 or half a cup of frosting that we made earlier, and this was enough to kind of make all the crumbs come together, so I just kneaded that into the dough or crumbs. And I found that for me the perfect size was this cookie scoop that I used for my cookies. I just took that and then rolled it out on balls and put it onto a cookie sheet. Then what I did was cool that in the fridge for 10 minutes, and once I took those out, I took melted chocolate that I put in a Ziploc bag and did like squiggly lines on top. Then I cooled that in the fridge for 10 minutes again and took these lollipop sticks, dipped them into the chocolate, and then stuck it into the cake balls about halfway in. And once I did that, I had to cool them again for 10 minutes. It's kind of repetitive, but it's necessary. And once I took the cake pops out, I kind of put them on this stand and took the buttercream frosting that we made earlier and did like a star kind of thingy and placed the cake pop on top. And I think it looks super, super pretty like this. I just feel like it looks really fancy, but it's actually so easy to do, which is why I love this so much. And that is literally how you do the cake pops. It was kind of a fail, but I turned the fail into a star, I guess.
So that is how I made the cake balls. I turned a fail into a win, I guess. Hopefully you guys liked this video. I know it's different, but I did used to do these in my early YouTube days, but I kind of railed off of that track because, like I said, they're just very time consuming. But you guys are requesting more cooking videos, so here, that's why I made it, I guess. Please give this video a big thumbs up because it literally took me so much time to put it together, but it was worth it in the end. That was it for today's video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Love you.